Hi folks, and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleek, and in this episode I'll be taking you through how to easily replace a color in Illustrator. Overall, we'll cover targeting your artwork and applying shift to color, which is the name of the adjustment that's going to allow you to replace a color in Illustrator. Alright, so let's get started by targeting the artwork. First thing I want to do is hit the V key on my keyboard to make sure I have the selection tool activated. Now I'm going to click once on my artwork. Notice over here in the appearance panel, it's telling me that I have the entire group targeted. That means I'm going to replace the color of the apple, the stem, and the leaf at the same time. What I'd like to do is just focus in on the apple itself. So I'm going to double click on that, and that brings me into this isolation mode. So basically, I'm inside of the group now. When I click on the mesh, I'm just focused on this mesh alone, and I can confirm that over here in the appearance panel. All right, so now that I got this guy targeted, I'm ready to apply shift to color. You could apply this adjustment to all types of vectors and embedded raster images. If you're working with a linked image, you're going to want to embed that image first in order to replace a color. If you'd like to apply a permanent change, what you want to do is go into the object menu, scroll down to filters, phantasm, and then apply shift to color. Just keep in mind, you won't be able to come back and make changes to this adjustment in the future. I'm going to hit escape to get out of that. For this tutorial, I'm going to go into the effect menu, find phantasm, and then choose shift to color. By going into the effect menu, I'm actually going to apply this as a live effect, which means I can make adjustments to this later. All right, clicking on shift to color is going to bring up the settings. Over here at the top, next to color, we have this little color chip. By default, it's set to this red, but when you click on it, it's going to bring up this color picker for you. All right, if your cube or your bar looks different than mine, just click on this top button over here next to H. That H stands for hue. If you have it set to any of these other buttons, notice the cube and the bar kind of switch up a little bit. All right, so I'm going to click on this top one for H, and I'm going to choose a different hue. I'm going to go with this yellowish green. Once I got the color that I'm ready to go with, I'm going to click OK. Now we have a new color in here, but notice nothing changes over here in our artwork. We do have the preview checked by default, but over here for shift, we've shifted 0%. So I'm going to click and drag to introduce a new value and then release. All right, so now we've shifted 20% and you see that updated over here on the artboard. I could also come in here and manually change this value. I'm going to go with 50% and then hit tab. And you see that updated over here in the artwork. Now you also have these basic options. These basic options are going to allow you to apply these adjustments to your fill, stroke, text, embedded image, and more. If you'd like this adjustment to not have any effect over any of these elements, just make sure that that box is unchecked and you're good to go. I'm going to click OK to apply that effect. Now we've replaced our color. Over here in the appearance panel, notice we have this live effect. So if I click on that link, I'm able to edit that adjustment in the future. I'm going to deselect my artwork so you get a better look at the change. Now, to get out of this isolation mode, it's really easy. Just double click on the artboard and you're good to go. When you click on the mesh, again, we're targeting that entire group all over again. And that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered targeting your artwork and applying shift to color. Make sure you watch the next episode in order to understand how to apply a temperature tint adjustment in Illustrator. And don't forget, all of our plugins are available for a free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.